Good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to start your sixth chapter of English, that is Birbal and the Washerman. So do you know who was the Birbal? Actually, Birbal was a very clever man and he was a minister in Akbar's court. Akbar was a great Indian emperor. So he was the wisest, you can say, minister of Akbar's court, and he was very well renowned about his cleverness. Because of his cleverness. So this is a very, you can say, interesting story in which the Birbal helps a washerman. So how? That we will read in this chapter. And before starting our reading portion, they have given you here some pictures and you have to judge the pictures or you have to, you can say, write the names of the characters shown in these pictures. So name of the characters and to which story these characters belong. So this is your task for the first page, and then moving to the second page now. So students, this story is like a play, and they have given you the different scenes, scene 1, scene 2, scene 3, and different characters are there. So the characters are Akbar, the emperor, and then the town crier. Town crier means to say a person who used to give announcements in the town at that time, because at that time there were no social media, no news channels were there, no televisions were there. So news were conveyed by a person who used to beat a drum in the town and then loudly speak the that particular news. So town crier means to say a person hai jo news ko town mein spread karta tha us time pe. Then comes here Kusum, the wife of washerman, and Dinu, the washerman. Washerman means to say dhobi. So Dinu and his wife Kusum and their children are there. Then courtiers and village folk means to say, the courtiers means to say the ministers in Akbar's emperor or Akbar's court, and village folk means to say people. And then Birbal, the clever man of Akbar court. Or then messenger is there and narrator is there. So I am reading the first scene. Scene number 1. The scene is that of a winter morning. Means there is a winter morning, and Akbar and Birbal are pacing the floor on the terrace of the palace. The terrace offers a good view of the river. Terrace means to say on the roof. They are standing. They are standing on the roof of the palace, Akbar and Birbal, and pacing the floor means to say they are moving to and fro. To and forth means to say they are moving forward direction, then comes back, then again. So they are just you can say walking on the roof of the palace, and from there you can say terrace. From their roof of the palace, there is a beautiful view of a river. So they are watching that river. Akbar. Now Akbar is saying to something to Birbal. So Akbar is saying that, Birbal, I have heard that the water in this river is extremely cold. Is that true? So Akbar is asking from the Birbal that the river water is very cold. I have heard from somewhere, somebody has told me that this river water is very cold. Is that true? Birbal, yes, your majesty, I have been told so. So Birbal ne bola, yes, my lord, your majesty means to say, he is just giving respect to the king. So he is saying, yes, your majesty, I have been told so. So he is saying that, yes, maine bola tha. So Akbar, what do you think will happen if a man stand in the river all through the night? Do you think he will die? So Akbar is asking, if a man stands in this river water, in this cold river water for one night, do you think he will die? So Birbal is saying, now certainly your majesty, no man will be able to survive the cold water for an entire night. So Birbal is saying that, yes, of course, my lord, your majesty, it's obvious that if one man stand in this this much cold river water for entire night, for one full night, then that person will definitely die. There is no doubt. So Akbar thinks for a while, then speaks, I have an idea. So Akbar was thinking for some time and then he said, I have an idea. So Akbar whispers something in Birbal's ear. Birbal is surprised at what he says, but he does not look too pleased. So now Akbar thinks for something and then he said, I have an idea, and then he whispers something in Birbal's ear. Whisper means to say speaking in a very low voice. So he said something in a very low voice in Birbal's ear, and Birbal was surprised to listen that thing, and he was not too much pleased, but he was surprised. So now scene number 2. So Akbar ने उस time कोई order दिया था और वो order अब Birbal ने आगे pass कर दिया है. अब scene number 2 उसी चीज़ का है. So scene number 2, It is evening, it is afternoon, and the setting is that of a town marketplace. A town crier beats his drum loudly and people come leaving their work and gather around him. So as you can see from the picture also, there is a person sitting on the horse and he is reading something from a paper, and all the other people around him listening to him very carefully. So the town crier loudly, he is saying that everyone listen, here is an order from the Emperor Shahanshah Akbar. Any man who will stand in the cold waters of the river in front of Emperor's palace all through the night will be amply rewarded. So the person is saying that listen, everyone listen carefully, that there is an order from the Shahanshah Akbar, and he says that if someone will stand for the whole night in the cold river water, the Akbar will give him award. Amply means to say very much award, full of money or coins, etc. So large amount of award, you can say. So he moves on making the same announcement at another busy corner of the town. The town people stand in small group discussing the announcement. It is clear that no one is ready to accept the challenge, but a poor washerman Dinu listens to the announcement and whispers something into his wife's ear. Now the town crier goes on into the whole town and he is giving the same announcement everywhere, but all people are very surprised, and they were surprised that no one will go and no one will stand in river just for money. But then a poor washerman, Dinu's ka name hai, and he listened about this thing and he whispers something into his wife's ear. So Dinu is saying to his wife Kusum, this is a good opportunity, this is a very good chance. He's saying if I should try my luck, he's saying that I should try my luck once. If I succeed in standing in the river, I will get reward and we will be able to live well. So he is saying to her wife that we are poor actually, if I do this task, we will get some money and it will be good for us. So now Kusum is saying that, are you sane? Insane, insane means to say, are you mad? Are you, you can say crazy, means to say, are you pagal? So no, don't ever think of taking such a risk. She is saying that no, you will not take this much risk. Dinu again, don't you worry, nothing will happen to me, after all I am used to washing clothes in cold water every day. So now Dinu is saying to his wife that please don't worry, there is nothing difficult for me because I am washing the clothes daily in the cold water, so this is not a difficult task for me. So now the scene number 3 is here. It is night, the washerman walks into the river and stands in the middle of it. Some people ask him not to risk his life. So in the scene 3, what happens, that Dinu, that old you can say poor washerman, he go to that river and went to that river, and then he stands in that river water, and then some people are asking from him that please don't risk your life, but he is doing that. So first man, now people, villagers are saying these things. First man was saying, I feel sorry for this poor washerman, why does he want to kill himself? So first person is saying that I am very sorry for this poor washerman, what he is doing, why he doesn't take care of his life. Second man is saying, I think he has gone mad, imagine doing such a foolish thing just for money, let's hope for he returns happily or safely. So second person is saying that I think he has gone mad, ki wo pagal ho gaya hai, imagine doing such a foolish thing just for money, and wo bol raha hai ki socho wo sirf paise ke liye itne foolish kaam kar raha hai, and let's hope he returns safely. Then the next morning Dinu is shivering badly. He had stood in the river all through the night and now wants his reward from the emperor. The people of the town are happy he has managed to survive through the night. So what happened next morning, the Dinu was shivering means to say wo kaamp raha tha, very badly means to say bahut buri tarah se kaamp raha tha. Why? Because he has stood for the whole night into that river water or into that cold water, and now he has done his task and now he wants his reward, and all people were happy that he, at least he is, you can say, alive, he is not dead. So Kusum happy and relieved. Now Kusum is saying, you have done it, means you have did your task very well, thank God you are fine, I have been so worried, I prayed for your safety for the whole night, and at last God has heard our prayers. You will now be rewarded. Now Kusum is saying that it's very good. I am happy now that you are safe and you stand safely for the whole night into that river, and God heard us prayers, heard our prayers, and now you will be rewarded by the emperor. Now scene number 4, in the Akbar's court, the emperor is sitting on the throne. Now the picture is given, this picture is related to scene number 4. The Akbar, the person sitting on the chair is Akbar. So, and the person in green, you can say, clothes, I think that is Birbal, and central one is fisherman, and then the pink person standing in the pink clothes is one of the ministers of the Akbar. So Akbar is sitting on the throne. Throne means to say high chair that king used to sit. So the emperor is sitting on his throne, Birbal is standing beside him, the courtiers and the guards are standing in the darbar. Dinu and his family enters the darbar, they bow before Akbar. So the scene is that Birbal is also standing there, the courtiers means to say all the ministers were standing there, guards are standing there in the darbar, and Dinu and his family enters the darbar. Wo bhi darbar mein aage, Dinu aur uski family, they bow before Akbar, means to say wo usko namaskar kar rahe hain, wo usko greet kar rahe hain Akbar ko. So moving to the next page now, Dinu is saying salutations to your majesty. He is bowing his head to in front of Akbar, paying his greetings to the Akbar. Akbar, welcome Dinu. You are indeed a brave man. You deserve the reward. So Akbar is saying that welcome, and you are a very brave person. You deserve this reward. Narrator: A maid brings a silver tray laden with gold coins. As Akbar is about to give the reward to Dinu, a courtier interrupts. So what happens there? A maid means to say a servant lady brings a tray laden with gold coin. Laden means full of gold coins, and Akbar was about to give that reward to Dinu, but actually at that time a courtier said something or interrupts the Akbar. So now courtier is saying, your majesty, please don't reward the washerman. He does not deserve the reward. He did not stand in river without any help. So the courtier is saying that do not give this reward to the washerman, because he do not deserve this reward. Why? Because he did not stand in the river without any help. He is saying that he was having some kind of help, that is why he is able to stand in that river. So all other courtiers were surprised and demanded an explanation. All others were saying, how you can say this, please explain, what are you saying? So courtier is saying, your majesty, the lights from the palace kept the washerman warm all through the night. Now the courtier is giving his stupid statement, and he is saying that, your majesty, because of the lights of the palace, he was able to stand in that river because of the warmth or because of the heat of the light. Because as we all know, all the bulbs or lights spread some kind of heat, emit some kind of heat. So he is saying that why he was able to stand in that river for the whole night, because of the lights of the palace, and those lights are giving him heat. So Akbar thoughtfully, you have a point. Well, in that case, this man shall not get no reward. So Akbar thinks for a while, and then he said, yes, I will not give this reward to this man. Dinu walks away sadly with his family. Birbal feels unhappy and goes into deep thought. Now that poor fisherman, a washerman, goes out of that darbar, and Birbal was also very unhappy that Emperor Akbar has not given the reward to that person. Now scene number 5. The next day in Akbar's court, all are sitting, but Birbal's chair is empty. Now on the next day, what happens in the Akbar's court? All the ministers were present, but Birbal was absent. So Akbar, where is Birbal? Why has he not come to the court? He is usually punctual. So Akbar is asking that where is Birbal? Why he hadn't come to the court yet? And he is saying that he is very punctual, means to say he always come in the court at very, you can say, always at time. So why he is late today? A messenger arrives, and messenger is saying, your majesty, Birbal is in his house and he says he will be late today. And messenger says that Birbal has conveyed a message that he is at his home and he will be late today. So Akbar asks the question, why? Now messenger again is saying, Your Majesty, he is cooking food and he says that it will take long. And messenger said that he is cooking food at his home and it will take long time, so he will be late. He will be late. And Akbar, angerly means to say he was having a strong anger towards Birbal. What nonsense! I shall go and find out what he is up to. So now Akbar is saying, what nonsense are you talking of? Just because of cooking food, he is not present. So I will go to the Birbal home or where he is cooking food and I will just check him. So Akbar gets up and walks quickly towards Birbal's house, followed by some courtiers and guards. So Akbar moves out of his court and goes towards Birbal's house. So other courtiers were also present along with Akbar. Now the scene number 6. At Birbal's house, Birbal is sitting near a fire on the ground. High above the fire is a pot suspended from a high pole. So now this picture is about at Birbal's house, and as you can see from the picture, the person is sitting is Birbal and standing is Akbar. And you can see Birbal is hanging up, suspended means to say he has hanged a pot on a long pole and below there is a fire. So Akbar, Birbal, what are you doing? Why have you kept the pot so far away or so far above the fire? Do you think this fire can cook your food? Now Akbar is asking from the Birbal and he is saying, what stupid are you doing? And the Akbar is saying that your pot is much away from the fire. How you can cook food like this? So Birbal said with a smile on his face, if this fire can't cook the food inside this pot, how can the lights of your palace warm Dinu in the cold water of river? So now Birbal with a smile on his face said, yes my lord, if this fire is unable to cook the food, if food will not be cooked like this, then how you can say that the lights of the palace were enough to warm Dinu in the cold water of river? So Akbar realizes that his decision in not rewarding the washerman was wrong and calls for him the next day. So now Akbar realized his mistake, that I was wrong. I should have given that reward to that person. So scene number 7. Next day in Akbar's court, Dinu comes with his family to the court. Akbar hands a tray of coins to Birbal, who gave it to Dinu, and Dinu and his family were very happy. All the people cheer and clap. So there is a happy ending, that on next day Akbar called that washerman, that poor washerman Dinu, at his court, and he rewarded a tray full of gold coins. So their family was very happy and all the people sitting in the court were very happy and cheerfully clapped. So this is all about the story, how the wisest man or how the cleverest man Birbal helped a poor washerman to get his reward, and how he was able to teach Akbar a lesson. So I hope you have enjoyed the story, and now there comes your exercise part. So now they have given you a few lines here and you have to arrange these sentences as they occur in the story, means in a sequence, in a chronological order, and then comes to the next page. Moving to the next page, they have given you some MCQs are here and you have to choose the correct MCQs answer. Then you have given some sentences and you have to answer the questions like who said this and to whom this was said. So try to solve all these questions, students. These are very simple. And then comes your grammatical portion. First one is your vocabulary portion, that is homonyms and homophones. So what are homonyms and homophones? Let us try to understand that with the help of examples. So first example that they have given you is that the campers realized that they had walked into the den of the bear. First sentence, what they are saying, camper means to say kuch persons the, maan lo ki wo kisi hill station pe camp lagane gaye the aur wo unhone realize kiya, unhone mehsoos kiya ki wo galti se kisi bear ki den mein ghus gaye hain. Den means to say gufa, bear means to say bhalu jo hota hai. So next sentence, Dinu had to bear the consequences of the courtier's advice to Akbar. So yahan pe bear, wahan pe bear ki meaning tha, to jo aapka bhalu hota hai, और सेकंड जो बियर है उसका मतलब होता है किसी चीज़ को टॉलरेट करना, किसी चीज़ को अपने ऊपर लेना. सो इन दिस वे द स्पेलिंग्स आर सेम हियर, देर आर टू वर्ड्स दैट इज बियर एंड बियर, बोथ आर हैविंग सेम स्पेलिंग्स, सेम प्रोनाउंसिएशन, बट द मीनिंग इज इंटायरली डिफरेंट. इन फर्स्ट सेंटेंस बियर मीन्स टू से एन एनिमल, एंड इन सेकेंड सेंटेंस बियर मीन्स टू से tolerate something. So similarly, they have given you one more example. So one more example is that Dinu told his wife that the reward will help them live well. So Dinu was saying to his wife that this reward will be good for them. This reward will help them to live well. Well means to say in a good way or in a you can say better way. So Dinu, next is Dinu used to draw water from the well. एंड सेकेंड उसने बोला है कि दीनू पानी कहाँ से निकालता था, वेल में से, कुएं में से. सो इन दीज टू सेंटेंसेज ऑल्सो द वर्ड दे हैव हाईलाइटेड इज वेल एंड बोथ द वेल्स आर हैविंग सेम स्पेलिंग सेम प्रोनाउंसिएशन बट हियर मीनिंग इज अगेन डिफरेंट. सो ऑल दीज काइंड ऑफ वर्ड्स लाइक द वर्ड बियर एंड वेल हैव डिफरेंट मीनिंग. दे आर स्पेल्ड एंड प्रोनाउंस्ड इन द सेम वे. So, however, the meaning in each case is different. We have learned that the words which have same spelling and have same pronunciation but different meanings are called homonyms. So, the words which are having same pronunciation, same spellings but a different meaning, they are having two different meanings. So, those words are called homonyms. And then comes another category of words that are called homophones. So, the next sentence is given, let us pray for his life and then the lion attacked its prey. So first pray jo hai pray hai aur second pray is prey. So what is the meaning of first pray? First pray means to say prarthna karna, bhagwan se kisi ke liye kuch bhi mangna. So second pray prey means to say shikar. So here the words are having same pronunciation but their spellings are different. Two different words are there, so definitely meanings will be different. On the other hand, second example is also given, at last God has heard our prayers. Means someone is saying that at last God has heard, Bhagwan ne hamari prayers sun li. Heard means to say sunna. Second, the farmer crossed the road with his herd. Now H-E-R-D, herd. Again, the pronunciation is same, but word is different. So, what is the meaning of this word? H-E-R-D, herd. H-E-R-D, herd means to say group of cattle, like group of sheep or group of cows, etc. So, farmer crossed the road with his herd means to say farmer ne road cross ki along with the group of sheep laga lo. So, the words like pray and pray have the same pronunciation, but are differently spelled and have different meanings. In the second set of sentences also, the words heard and heard are also spelled differently and have different meanings. So these kind of words which are having same sound, same pronunciation, but actually spellings are different and also their meaning is different. So those kind of words are called homophones. So what you have to do, students, next, fill in the blanks with the correct homonyms from the box. You may use a word in more than one sentence. So here they have given you some words and you have to fill in the blanks using these homonyms, and I think you should try these. First one is, my 4-year-old sister can write her name in capital letters. So answer is capital letters. Then again, Anu said that she would not buy a dash for her friend. Instead, she would make one with her own hands. So, what could be the answer here? Present. Present means to say gift. So, in this way, you have to solve all these fill-ups and you have to fill these words. You will find that in some sentences, the word has some different meaning. In another, it will be of different meaning. So in this way you have to solve all these exercises, and then comes your B part. Choose the correct option to complete these sentences. So Jack and Jill fetched a pail of water. So pail of water means to say one pail, P-A-L-E, pail means to say light yellow color, and P-A-I-L means to say bucket. So अगर कोई वाटर फिल कर रहा है तो वो तो बकेट में ही करेगा, तो फिर वहाँ पे आपका आंसर क्या होगा? P-A-I-L. Jack and Jill fetched a pail of water, P-A-I-L. You have to take. Then the girl was sent home because she felt weak and had fainted. So girl को क्या किया, उसको होम घर पे भेज दिया बिकॉज वो बड़ा वीक फील कर रही थी और बेहोश हो गई. फेंट मीन्स बेहोश हो जाना. सो वीक अब कौन सा आएगा, W-E-A-K, वीक, और W-E-E-E-K. So वीक दो वर्ड्स हैं, दोनों का प्रोनाउंसिएशन सेम है बट स्पेलिंग्स आर डिफरेंट, सो मीनिंग्स आर डिफरेंट. सो फर्स्ट वीक मीन्स टू से जो कमज़ोर होता है, सो फ्रजाइल हो, डेलीकेट हो. सो डब्ल्यू ई ए के इज़ द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर हेयर, बिकॉज सेकेंड वीक मीन्स टू से डेज ऑफ वीक, लाइक संडे मंडे ट्यूजडे, सो दोज कम्प्लीट सेवन डेज आर कॉल्ड डेज ऑफ वीक. सो हेयर यू हैव ऑल्सो बी वेरी केयरफुल टू चूज दीज करेक्ट ऑप्शंस एंड देन आई थिंक यू रेस्ट यू विल सॉल्व बाई योर सेल्फ. देन कम्स योर डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिव प्रोनाउंस एंड डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिव एडजेक्टिव. सो वॉट आर दीज वर्ड्स, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दीज थिंग्स. नाउ we have learnt about demonstrative adjectives, these adjectives that qualify a noun by pointing it to. So we have heard about these things in a previous chapters. First one is, this book is very interesting. Those monkeys have terrorized the colony. So this those means to say they are pointing about where is that book or where those monkeys are. So in this way these words are called demonstrative adjectives. So moving to the next page now. Here are some more examples of demonstrative adjectives. Notice how the adjective comes just before the noun in each sentence. This coffee mug belongs to Ritu. So they are talking about the coffee mug. This is denoting that coffee mug. Then I did not write on that board. So that word is denoting the place of that board. And who kept these sandwiches here? Please bring me those files. So all these words, like read these sentences, this is a fruit. Fruit means to say singular. If there are this means to say singular. If we are using these, that is plural, and if we are using this, that is singular. I have already told you earlier also. So this is used to denote nearby object, and those or that is used to denote far objects. So this and that are used in the singular form, in the with the singular objects, and these and those are used with plural objects, and this and these is for near ones, and that and those for the far ones. So in this way you have to solve, you have to read all these things, and then they have given you. Next is possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. So we have seen that possessive pronouns shows ownership. It replaces the noun in the sentence to show possession. For example, my uncle gave me a guitar, the guitar is mine. So again, my uncle gave me a guitar and this guitar is mine. Mine means to say this guitar belongs to me. So in this way, these words like mine, yours, his, her, all these words are known as possessive pronoun because they gives the ownership or the belongingness of thing. So take this money, it is yours. Robin was wearing a blue coat, the coat is his. So all these words are the possessive pronouns. So possessive pronouns is used to instead of nouns, so it is followed by a noun. A possessive adjective then comes. So possessive adjective describe a noun by showing possession. It is followed by a noun. For example, could you please pass me my notebook? So they are asking to pass their notebook. So my, you can say my is a possessive adjective. Then I want to return your water bottle. Whose water bottle? Yours water bottle. So in this way, they have given you some possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives in the below tables. Read all these examples and carefully, and you will be able to understand the difference between possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. So now what you have to do, use any three possessive pronouns and their corresponding possessive adjectives in the sentences. Write these sentences in your notebook. So what you have to do, you have to use these possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives to form sentences. So then comes your study skills, then spellings, able, able, and able, ible words. So there are many words that are spelled with the suffix able and able. We often get confused which of these prefixes to use. Here are some guidelines that might be useful when using ible able or able able. So now we will learn the use of these words, and moving to the next page for that. So students, you might have heard some words which end with these kind of you can say sound. So when the word end with the spelling able, the main part of the word is usually a complete word in itself. Means if we remove this able word from the back side of that word, the left behind the word that is left behind is having a complete meaning. Means that word has some kind of existence and complete meaning. For example, readable, acceptable. So if we remove the able part from these words, you know that read is having a proper meaning, accept is also having a proper meaning. So however, when the root words end with e, or then e suffix is dropped. For example, if the word is advisable, able is written along with advice, and from the advice advice, we have dropped e from here, then we have put able here. So in this way, you have to be careful about these words. Then comes, when the root words end with consonant, then the consonant is doubled before suffix is attached. Means forgettable. So forget me, there is a single T, and in when you are writing able along with it, you have to make the T double. So it comes in some special cases, not in all cases. So you have to be careful about that. Then comes the word ible. So when a word end with ible, the word that ends before the suffix is attached is not a complete word. So as we have read from the above examples, if the word is ending with the word able, and if you remove that able, the remaining word has a complete meaning. Read is having meaning, accept is a meaningful word. But if you remove this word ible, then the remaining word has no meaning. Like audible is given. What is the meaning of audible? Audible means that you can listen properly. Any audio, any voice that is can be heard properly. Okay? So if we remove the word ible, then aud has no meaning. So in this way, it makes no sense. So that is why you can recognize where you have to write ible and where you have to write able. So they have given you some example. You have to solve this, and you may use the dictionary. So first word terror. It has no meaning. This word is having no meaning. So what you have to add here, you have to write ible, which is terrible. Terrible means to say koi bhi dravni cheez, bhyanak si cheez. Then comes understand. Now understand is a complete word. Understand means to say kisi cheez ki kisi ko samajhna. So it is having a meaning. So iske aage aap kya lagaoge? able, understandable. Then again comes reverse. Reverse has no meaning itself. It is not a proper word. So here you have to add the word ible, then it will become reversible. Then again comes depend. So depend is a proper word. As you know, depend means to say kisi pe nirbhar hona. So iske aage aap kya lagaoge? able, that is dependable. So in this way you have to complete this exercise. Then comes your listening part. Students, I have already told you that from where you have to assess the listening part, you just have to open this chapter from your My Bag app, that is your sixth chapter, The Beeble and the Washerman, and then you have to download the listening audio and then listen that audio properly. You may listen that audio 2 to 3 times to understand that audio properly. And then in that video, they have given you some facts about the great personalities like APJ Abdul Kalam and Raja Ramon Rai. So they have given something about these personalities, and then they have written here all the four, you can say about four personalities, and you have to match that properly, that which belongs to which. Like he was the 11th president of India. He spent a lot of his time interacting with students because he wanted to help them ignite their imagination. So you have to match this word, this you can say work, with the personality's name, whether it was it belongs to APJ Abdul Kalam or Raja Ram Mohan Rai, or it you can say it belongs to Mother Teresa or Aryabhatta. So in this way you have to match these words. But before doing that, must listen that listening part, that listening audio, that is there is in your My Bag app and within that chapter, this chapter. So moving to the next part now. So students, you have to leave this for the time being because this is a classroom discussion. Then comes your writing part. So a summary is a brief account of the main points of a story or a text. It does not contain details of the text. So they are telling you about the summary. What is summary? Summary means to say किसी story का conclusion. आपको and आपने पूरी story read कर ली and उसके बाद आपको उसमें जो भी main part लगा उसको आपने 3-4 lines में summarize कर दिया. So that is called summary. A brief account or a conclusion. So they have given you an example. So they have given you the example of the poem Humpty Dumpty. So all of you have read Humpty Dumpty in your lower classes, in your kindergarten sections. So then what is the meaning of that poem Humpty Dumpty? The summary of that poem was an egg named Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall and fell down. He broke and could not be put together again. Means that poem was about an egg whose name was Humpty Dumpty, and that egg fall from a well, from a wall, and then that egg broke up, and as we all know that then if once broken it can't be put together again. So that was the summary of that poem Humpty Dumpty. So what you have to do here, read a text means you have to read any poem or story or essay carefully and note down the main points or the key messages. Then organize these in a flow chart and write down these points in your own words. So write a summary of the favorite story in not less than 150 words. So means you what you have to do, they have given you the steps to how to write summary and follow these steps also, and just read anything like we have read this story also or any of the story that you like, read that story properly and then write the summary of that story within 150 words. So I hope you have enjoyed this chapter very well. Now try to solve all the exercise given here and complete your chapter. Thanks for listening and have a nice day.